Hello, for this Excel tip, we're going to talk about logic formulas. So logic formulas are very helpful in Excel. And we're going to talk about a couple different versions of logic formulas. But first, let me just show you how this sheet is laid out. So in this case, we're going to be comparing a couple different numbers. We're going to be comparing the numbers in cell A2, in cell B2, and in cell C2. And we're going to be comparing them a couple different ways. But first, let me show you the first way. So this is, if we have cell, these are the formulas we're going to be comparing, and this is the evaluation of that formula. So for example, in this case, the formula is A2 greater than B2, and so this cell is just equals A2 greater than B2, so it evaluates that formula. Just to give you, to show you what all these formulas are. Okay, so let's look. So this little sign means greater than, and so this formula is checking whether or not A2 is greater than B2. So if A2 is greater than B2, this will return true, and if A2 is not greater than B2, this will return false. So let's see what it returns now. Since 5 is greater than 3, it returns true. Now, if I change this one, let's say I change this to 8, it's going to return false because now A2 is not greater than B2. Now let's see what happens in the special case when A2 equals B2. So when A2 equals B2, this returns false because A2 is not greater than B2. They're equal. Now if we go back to sort of our original one, this is A2 less than B2, and now A2 we see is not less than B2, so this should be false. So the same exact thing here and whatnot. Now we have, this is just meaning A2 equal to B2, so now if we change this to 5 to make them equal, this will be true. And again, notice that these two, the first two, are false. So now if we look at the row 8 and 9, we have less than or equal to and greater than or equal to. And in this case, unlike the greater than and less than, these evaluate to true. And these are going to be the same as rows 5 and 6, except when these two are equal. So for example, if I put in a 3 here, you can see that the less than one is the same, so these two are the same, right, because they're both less than, and these two evaluate as the same. So the only time that the greater than or equal to is going to be different than the greater than is that if the two cells are equal. And that makes sense. Okay, so the rest of our formulas here are a little bit different. The rest of our formulas use the and or formulas. So let's just go over what those two mean. So for and statements to be true, all statements must be true. So for and statements to be true, all statements must be true. So let's go over what that means for this. So all of these statements must be true. So A2 must equal B2, and B2 must equal C2. So if we just make A2 and B2 equal, we're still going to get false here. Because even though this first statement is true, the second statement is not. So it's false. So now, if we want to make this true, if we make these all 5, we see that A2 is equal to B2 and B2 is equal to C2. So since all the statements are true, the and statement evaluates to true. Okay? So we can see that there. Now let's look at OR statements. For OR statements to be true, only one statement must be true. So more than one statement may be true, but only one must be true. So let me show you what I mean by that. So in this case, both of these statements are true. So the OR statements evaluates to true. But let's go ahead and change this last one to 6. And when we do that, we can see that the AND statement goes to false because both of these statements aren't true. But the OR statement stays as true because the A2 equals B2 is true, and the B2 equals C2 is false. So at least one, or only one, is true. So I guess the best way to say that, instead of only one, we can just say at least one statement must be true. That's a better way to say it. And we'll wrap the text. So now let's look at a couple of the other ones, just as another examples. In this case, A2, and let's go back to our original. In this case, A2 is not less than B2. So right away, since we know that for and, we know all of them have to be true. So right away, we know this one's not true, so that it has to be false. It actually doesn't even matter what this one is. So now let's look at this one. A2 is less than B2. That's not true. But A2 is less than C2, so that's why this is true. And then you can sort of see now it's the same thing here, but we just have greater than or equal to. And since nothing's equal here, these ones are the same as that. So if we made these equal up here, it might change. So what I would recommend is you're not probably going to get all of this from this short video. I would recommend making a spreadsheet similar to this one and really trying some of these evaluations and seeing what's happening to really get this concept. Thank you for watching.